Children, in the previous video, I gave you the summary. Now, in this video, we will read the poem. Please read along with me with the correct pronunciation. And side by side, I will tell you the meanings of some new words also. Fine? So, let's start with the reading portion. Macavity is a mystery cat. He is called the Hidden Paw. For he is the master criminal who can defy the law. He is the bafflement of the Scotland Yard, the Flying Squad's despair. For when they reach the scene of crime, Macavity is not there. Now children, these are the first four lines of the poem. Now in the first line, there is a word hidden paw. Hidden, you all know, this is the past participle form of hide, which means to keep or put something secretly, which you cannot find, which one cannot find. And paw means foot of animal or bird, animal. Hidden paw is an adjective used here for Macavity, because Macavity was so smart and so swift in vanishing that after committing the crime, he immediately vanishes from the place. That's why this adjective is used for Macavity. Or in other words, you can say one can see the Macavity normally at many places, but on the next second when you look for him, you will not find that cat. That is why it is called the hidden paw. Now come on to the next word. In the next line, the next word is defy. Defy means to disobey. In the next line, the word is bafflement, means confusion. And in the last line, the word is despair. Despair means hopelessness, means no hope at all. Now come on to the next line.
Macavity, Macavity, there is no one like Macavity. He has broken every human law. He breaks the law of gravity. His powers of levitation would make a fakir stare. And when you search the scene of crime, Macavity is not there. You may seek him in the basement. You may look up in the air. But I tell you once and once again, Macavity is not there.
Now children, let's come on to the word meaning session. Now see, in the first line, Macavity, Macavity, there is no one like Macavity. He has broken every human law. He breaks the law of gravity. Children, according to the law of gravity, everything must come to the ground. But this cat has broken the law of gravity. His powers of levitation. In the next line, there is a word levitation. Levitation means the thing which I just talked about in this line, floating in the air without any support. Fine? This means levitation. Though generally cats do not fly, never flies in fact, never fly, but this Macavity can. This is levitation. Fakir. In the same line, there is a word fakir. Fakir, you can say like a saint or sage, or the person who dedicated to the god. They stare. Stare means looked fixedly. Look fixedly or gaze toward anything. Seek, search for anything or look for anything. And when you reach the scene of crime, Macavity is not there. You may seek. Seek means you can look for, you can see him, you can search him in the basement. Basement means an underground place or cell. Cell here means a small room or store like structure. An underground place or cell is called basement. Underground means completely under the ground. Now come on to the next stanza is Macavity is a ginger cat. He is very tall and thin. You would know him if you saw him, for his eyes are sunken in.
His brow is deeply lined with thought. His head is highly domed. His coat is dusty from neglect. His whiskers are uncombed. He sways his head from side to side with movements like a snake. And when you think he's half asleep, he is always wide awake.
Now let's come on to the word meaning session. Sunken in the second line, sunken in means deep set eyes. Domed, in the next line, the last word is domed, in the third line. Domed means round shaped, like this, round in shape. Dusty, full of dust or dirty. Next is neglect, in the same line. Neglect means ignore. Next word in the same line, whiskers. Whiskers means the hairs that grows near the mouth of an animal, like cat, rat. Then next word again in the same line, uncombed. Uncombed means the word with the hairs which are not combed or curled, not straight, sways, moving slowly side by side. Now come on to the last four concluding lines of the poem. Last four lines are McCavity, McCavity, there is no one like McCavity. For he is a fiend in feline shape, a monster of depravity. You may meet him in a by street, you may see him in the square, but when a crime is discovered, then McCavity is not there. So these are the last four lines. Now come on to the word meaning session. In the second line, there are three words actually. Fiend, feline and depravity. All the three are, I think, new for you. Fiend means a devil, a bad man, a bad person. While feline is you can say a species or related to a cat. Feline means relating to a cat. Or depravity means moral corruption. The thing which is against the civilian laws, that is called moral corruption. Now this is all from the reading session, children. I hope you all will read the poem again and again with correct pronunciation, like me only. And one more thing I want to tell you before ending the video. Like children, the poems always have a rhythm and a tune and a melody. So please try to recite poems and read poems in the same way. Like see, the last words are rhyming. If you remember, in my first video, I told you about this when we did the first poem, The Ant and the Cricket, that poems have a rhythm. So try to read the poem in the same rhythm. I am reading the last four lines again. McCavity, McCavity, there is no one like McCavity, for he is a fiend in feline shape, a monster of depravity. You may meet him in a by street, you may see him in the square, but when a crime is discovered, then McCavity is not there. Fine, so please read the poem in the same way. Till bye bye.